The current system methodology will continue to apply with some modifications. And the first modification is that the maximum annual increase limits will no longer apply in 2020. So this is the 13% maximum annual increase limits that currently apply on the system. These will not apply in 2020. Secondly, the floor rates of the current system will be increased by 20%. And finally, there will be tax harmonization in 2020 at the level of Group 1 cap rates, increased by 5% compared to the Group 1 cap rates in 2019. That takes me into the second period of time, which is the years 2021 to 2025. And this is where we begin to talk about the self-declared system as it were. The methodology is the self-declared system, and very importantly to recognize this is an opt-in, so countries can choose to determine whether they wish to partake in this particular system or not. The proposed date of implementation for the self-declared system for all member countries other than those who are wishing to access the dual speed provision will be the 1st of January 2021. The proposals also provide an opportunity for member countries who meet certain criteria to be able to accelerate the implementation of self-declared rates if they choose to do so. And the main criteria is how if you have inbound mail volumes in excess of 75,000 tons in 2018, you may accelerate the implementation of self-declared rates, which means that you would also be exempt from the transition provisions that would apply to everyone else. Importantly, if you choose to exercise this right to accelerate your self-declaration rates, it would be done on a reciprocal basis. Two other things to take note of in relation to the dual-speed accelerated implementation. Firstly, designated operator invoking this particular right, wherever possible, is required to make available to the sending designated operator in a non-discriminatory way any discounts for volume and regional split which are available in the receiving country's domestic service. This again is to encourage appropriate pricing in recognition of pre-processing efficiencies. And finally, should you hit the 75,000 ton threshold and if you choose to exercise this right, what is also required of you is a what's referred to as an accelerated implementation contribution of $40 million, which will go towards the union's funds, of which $16 million will be to secure the postal security of our network, and $24 million to any long-term liabilities that may exist on the books of the union. I will keep going through all of the different parameters to indicate where we ended up with option E in terms of agreed solutions. The next is ceiling rates, calculated on the basis of 11 tariffs of priority single-piece domestic items. And these effectively act as a ceiling in that should you choose to self-declare, your self-declared rates cannot be higher than those ceiling rates. And the way in which we go about determining these ceiling rates will depend on a number of business rules which are also articulated in the relevant proposals in terms of changes to Articles 28 and so on. Very importantly, there is a cost-to-tariff ratio of 70%. This is a baseline cost-to-tariff ratio of 70%. And there is, and this was something that was greatly debated and we ended up with a very good compromise. There was agreement to also provide for what's referred to as a cost-to-tariff escalator, basically an adjustment mechanism that allows countries that invoke the accelerated self-declaration system to also be able to adjust the cost-to-tariff ratios by 1% on an annual basis, but capped up to a maximum of 80%. Now, all of this is of course subject to it being validated by the competent authority of the particular designator that has purview over the designated operator, and with relevant information and evidence also provided to the International Bureau. Finally, on cap rates, we will no longer have cap rates from 2021 onwards with the self-declared system. A few more parameters. On item to kilogram ratio, there was in principle agreement that in the first year in 2020, it should be 44.5%. But from 2021 onwards, it would be within a bandwidth of plus or minus 5% annual adjustment. The next one, maximum annual revenue increases. This was highly debated, and it took us a long time to get to a very acceptable compromise. And just again, recalling the fact that in 2020 there'll be a harmonization of the cap rates at the level of Group 1 cap rates increased by 5%. And then the maximum annual revenue increase limits will kick in. From 2021, it will be at 15%, at 2022, 15%, 2023, 16%, 2024, 16%, and finally, at 2025, 17%. What this means cumulatively across the 6 years, from 2020 to 2025, you will see a maximum annual revenue increase limit of 119% for Group 1, 148% for Group 2, and 164% for Group 3. The next parameter was floor rates, and this too was discussed considerably, and there was a genuine move within the House to try and address the concerns of particularly groups 2 and 3 countries, and clearly there was a shift towards that. We landed with a 20% increase in 2020 with an agreement on 5% annual increases between 2021 and 2025. Now, these flow rates will apply to all flows, whether you are subject to self-declared rates or not. Finally, and this is my last slide, Mr. Chairman. There was also some very good discussions about the applicable thresholds that that should apply in relation to Group 2 and Group 3 target system countries, as well as Group 4 countries in the transitional system. And again, there was a clear concern in trying to address the vulnerabilities of these of member countries in these groups. For Group 2 and Group 3 countries, in terms of their flows to Group 1 target system countries, any of these flows below 25 tons, these will not be subject to self-declared rates. And likewise, in the case of flows to, from, and between countries in Group 4, flows below 100 tons will not be subject to self-declared rates. So there's a fair bit of protection built into this package to meet the concerns of countries in both Group 2, Group 3, and of course Group 4 in the transitional system. Finally, very importantly, and as a response to concerns raised by many member countries, of the impacts, the likely impacts of a 100-ton threshold for Group 4 countries on renewal and the arbitrage opportunities that may be created. As part of the deal, there was agreement that there should be a proposal to change the convention, Article 2810, in relation to the definitions of bulk milk in order to allow us to deal with any renewal consequences. Now, this proposal, as you would have seen it originally as submitted to Congress, was a proposal from Switzerland and various other countries. It is now part of a package of option B, and therefore should the package be approved today by Congress, it will therefore be a critical element of the agreed parameters. So Mr. Chairman, just to conclude again, we have made available online all of the proposals that give effect to what you've seen on the slides. And to repeat the numbers again, you'll see them in proposal 2028.101, 2028.4, option B, 2029.6, option B, and finally 20.30.8, option B. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.